welcome back. Now, most of us already spoil our pets with treats and toys. But why buy a standard toy when you can get your pet the latest gadget? Who better to show us that it's than our tech expert, Colin Baker. Good morning to you, Colin.
Thanks a lot, Al.
And you have your lovely dog with you
this is Loxy. Loxy's pretty excited about being here this morning, and she was very excited about meeting you, Al.
Look, isn't she gorgeous?
She's modelling the gadgets this
modeling
morning.
Modelling the gadgets. Hey, Loxy.
Now, as you can see,
yes.
She's pretty excited.
But yeah, she's laid back.
I think most dogs, we love her to bits more than anything else in the world. And last year, she went missing when we were on a walk down in Wexford on the beach. And I got her a little tracking device for her collar.
Okay, since then. And is that what this first device is here? And so it's a pet tracker.
Exactly. And it's €99. It goes straight onto her collar. It actually uses a SIM card. So you get a SIM card from any of the providers, pop it in. And you set it up through an app on your phone. And a couple of advantages there. So if you are worried about your dog going missing...
So this has to be attached to her.
It's actually attached. It's very, very light, as you can see. So it really doesn't disturb her. She doesn't seem to mind it. She's actually wearing one at the minute. And what it does is you can set a geofence around your garden. So it alerts you if she goes outside the garden. So if she finds a way out through the hedge,
good idea.
It'll alert you straight away. If she does go missing, you can track her on almost like a Google Map interface on your phone. That's about 4 days on one charge, so you do have to charge it every 4 days, which is a little bit of a nuisance. But again, it's well worth
it. So you have that tracking. So if she's gone outside that perimeter that you've set,
exactly,
it goes off.
It'll alert you on your phone.
But then if she does get away, you can track
it. You can just go into the app and see exactly where she is.
Now,
there is dog napping, obviously, as well. But the size of the thing, I think they probably figure it out. It's a tracking device.
And when you see people and the rewards that they want to give to try and get their dogs back or their cats back.
It's a genuine fear. So I do have her on the lead an awful lot of the time, just in case, because she's actually very good and well-behaved. But if she sees a CAT, she goes absolutely nuts and she chases them.
All right.
So that's
a good idea then for that. The next one that we have, the keep a spot quiet.
This is an interesting idea that we've been using for the last year, and it's a cycling ultrasound device. Effectively, it's a way of training dogs not to bark. It's just negative feedback. It's similar to you saying, Loxy, stop barking. Now, when Loxy sees a CAT in the evening, she tends to go nuts. She thinks she sees something in the garden. She goes absolutely mad. It's the only time she barks. She's generally very good. And what this does is it emits a sound that only they can hear. And it's just at the volume and intensity that's like, oh, okay, right, I won't do that again. And she'll still bark every evening for about 5 seconds, but it's not as intense, and she knows, okay, right, you got me.
It's not like an electric shock.
It is literally emitting a dual-tone ultrasound that they can hear, and it's kind of annoying. It'd be like an alarm sound to you.
Okay, so when they start barking,
It's only when they bark. It only emits it when they bark. So again, she'll do that every evening, but only for about 5 seconds.
So you have this in the house then, or you don't have them?
We actually have that mounted right up beside the window that she tends to jump up at and bark out. Mumma also used it she got a new sofa there last year, and she used this. So every time she'd jump on the sofa, she'd press the button on it to set it off.
You have to go over and...
You don't have to. When Loxy barks, this will actually go off, but you can manually use it as well. So you can press a button manually and get it to let off that.
So if she kept jumping up on the couch that you didn't
you
want
just
to
press
every
the
time
button
you did
when
it.
She does it.
So is that learning process then of every time she jumps up on the couch just so I won't jump
it's
on the
couch? It's a simple negative feedback tool for training your dog.
Do you actually think it works?
It definitely works for the barking, absolutely. She still jumps up on the sofa, to be honest. But that's okay.
Haven't been pressing it enough.
But it's very much working for the barking. And it's nice because she'll still bark, but she just won't do that sort of half hour of incessant barking at a ghost cat.
Wow. Okay. Furbo treat. Love this.
I'll show you this now if I can get back on. So what this is, I think it's a brilliant idea and actually really, really hard to get. It took me a couple of weeks to get. If you're away from your dog, and we tend to be around Loxy most of the time, but if you're at work, your dog's at home, obviously, dogs get lonely very, very quickly.
Yeah.
And what this allows you to do is, I suppose it's like dog Skype.
We're looking at the video of it here because we've seen it. So it's basically, You're talking to your
dog.
You
set it up with the app. There's a camera on here. Yeah. There's treats in the top here. There's a dispenser here. You can actually go in here into the app from anywhere in the world. You're sitting in work. You go in. You can see your dog. And what this is the really cool part, you can dispense a treat by just jabbing on the button
okay,
down
so
there.
Go on.
And a treat comes
dispense
out here.
Dispense a treat then.
And the Wi-Fi has gone down. So for some reason, we can't actually get it to dispense the treat. But it pops out there.
It was working there. 2 minutes ago.
It was. Yeah, yeah. But that's the Wi-Fi in here is a bit, there's so much equipment around. But great idea, fantastic idea, €199, and Loxy absolutely adores
so
it.
So if you have a dog that you sort of a couple of hours every day,
yeah, like
you can Skype them, and yeah. So you can talk to them.
Oh, you can talk to them
you.
Through it and everything,
they'll
through your phone, through the app, through the device, it's quite loud,
and
quite
then
clear.
Do you want a treat, and the treats come out.
Exactly, and the little light flashes and all that, and Loxy absolutely adores it. It's not a replacement for the family being around you, being around the dog, but it is, she really gets excited when she's on it. You go on the camera and you'll see her on her own at home and kind of moping a bit, and she gets very excited
have
when
we got a treat
and
for
you
her
talk
there.
To her. We'll give her a little treat.
Give her a little treat.
On, take it out the top there.
Oh, here we go. Here.
Loxy.
Do you want a treat?
Alan has something for you.
There you go. There you go.
She's went for
good
a treat.
Girl. You're a good girl. Sit. There
See?
You go.
Paw,
Sit.
Ask her for paw.
Give me your paw.
Look at that. Good girl, Loxy. I'm
good
so
girl.
Proud.
Good girl.
That brings us on to the next little gadget. Do you know what? My sister was laughing at me for buying these. I wear a fluorescent jacket when I'm out walking at night.
Yeah.
And I mean, it's very important.
I've seen lots of dog owners with these in the dark evenings during the winter.
My sister was laughing at me saying, why would Loxy need to be seen? She does because she's down there. She's even harder to see than I am for the cars.
Yeah.
So if she actually, this is USB charged, and they're from about €10, €10, €15. So really, it's a proper collar. They can be different sizes. And
I've
different
seen
colours.
A lot of people over the winter because I go out walking and. Yeah. I've seen a lot of these, and you're just looking at it in the distance. You go, what's that? And then it's the dog.
Honestly, I think it's even because Loxy's down there, so she can't be seen as clearly as I can.
Like
so
even for cyclists, or if they do tend to run out in the road a bit or whatever, even
so
though you have them on the lead.
So you agree with me?
Yeah, I think they're a great idea.
My sister is wrong. This is
and so for what? It's 10 to 20
It's about €10, €15, and there's
and
loads of different versions of them available. The one I got is rechargeable through USB, so you don't even have to replace batteries. So it's really, it's a must for every dog, I reckon.
Now, this is a cat feeder.
We have to do something for cats, and maybe you shouldn't say it too loud on Oxy, but apparently... Where's the cat? Is there a
Where's
cat?
Where's the cat?
Oh, do you
Where's
get her barking?
Cat? Where's the cat?
This is a great device. A good friend of mine actually pointed this out to me because she has three cats, and two of the cats end up starving because one of the cats is a bit of a king and ends up eating all the food.
Yeah.
Now, this feeder, as you can see, it's closed off on the top here. And you put the cat's food in, and it's actuated and activated by the chip that's on there. So if your cat is chipped and the cat walks up to this feeder, top of it opens up. Now, if you don't have the cat chipped, there's a little collar tag that comes with it. You mount onto the collar and it has the same effect. And the idea is that one cat has that one feeder. A lot of the time when you have two or three cats, apparently, one cat will end up eating all the food and getting fat and the other cat doesn't get a look in. There's always a dominant one.
So,
and of course, this ensures...
But if the cat who has the tag comes up and opens it, the other one will rush up anyway.
Very clever, yeah. But they've actually designed the size of it and this device...
That they can't fit in.
Here, that it really does work. And I've watched a lot of reviews on this. And a friend of mine, as I say, has three cats and she finds it fantastic for that. This is specifically for the cat who doesn't tend to get a look in. And because it opens up that way... So you can't access it from there or from the side, as you can see here. So they've really thought it out. Really clever device.
Very good. And that's 129. And these are all available here in Ireland.
Yeah, well, most of them, like, what I always do is I stick them on our website and then I link them to whoever provides the product. So anyone with any interest, pop on the website. Did you hear about this drone dog walking in the States?
No.
Yeah, they started developing these drones to walk your dog in the States. Not sure how I feel about it.
No.
But I don't think Loxy, I think the whole idea with going for a walk is going out for a walk,
you're going with them, not the
spend
drone.
Spend time with the dog.
So are you at home?
You're at home and the drone takes the dog around your neighbourhood
and
you
back.
Can kind of track them on the app. I don't know. I don't think Loxy would like that.
No, I don't think Loxy would like that as well. Loxy, you were absolutely gorgeous. Thank
she
you very
good.
Much.
I'm so proud of you. Well done. Well, I have a sausage for you here. Where did the sausage go?
Alan, sausage.
Did you eat her sausage?
No, I haven't eaten our sausage.
I know, I had a sausage there.
An actual sausage.
An actual sausage.
No, all right.
No, it's gone. Alan ate your sausage.
Okay, we didn't take your sausage, Loxie, I swear. Simon Delaney probably has the sausage over there. Coming up next, stylist Celia Holman-Lee will be injecting some life into your mid-season wardrobe. We'll see you in a few minutes.